movement piece for cello and piano, composed by composer Astor Piazzolla. This piece expresses the spirit of Nouveau Tango, in English is New Tango, a melding of traditional tango rhythms and jazz-inspired syncopation. This piece is written in 1982 for the great Russian cellist Rostropovich, who did not play this piece until 1990. Although structured in single movement, this piece has three broad sections. It opens with an indication tempo di tango, in which strongly accented tango rhythms. In the second section, Piazzolla indicated with libro e cantabile, means free and singing. It contains extensive dialogue between the cello and piano. And the final section for Piazzolla indicated giocoso, means humorous, presents a mood of electric energy and even humor. The cellist to be challenged to play tons of double stops at the end of the piece, and also cello and the piano to be challenged to play some glissandos, which means sliding rapidly through this musical scale. And the second piece we're going to play is Oblivion. Oblivion is one of Astor Piazzolla's most popular tangos. This piece became widely known through the soundtrack of a film called The Mad King. This short piece, to be recorded so many versions, like cello version, violin version, oboe, even orchestra. And this piece is one of Piazzolla's most traditional tango, less jazzy and Bartokian than his other well-known tango pieces. And the third piece we're going to play is called Liber Tango, but Hyunjin will be the one to talk about the piece before we play it. And thanks again for watching and supporting us. Hope you enjoy the show.